As you know by now, climate change can have wide-reaching impacts. We hear a lot about fluctuating temperatures, damage from rising sea levels, places like the Bahamas and Puerto Rico recovering from extreme amounts of rain and flooding. But at the same time, other areas don't have enough water. In parts of India this year, people waited in long lines for clean water and had to ration water for bathing, cooking, and drinking. In Thailand, a drought brought water levels so low that it revealed the ruins of a Buddhist temple. We wanted to find out more about the impact of climate change on droughts, so we went to the experts at NASA.
Why does NASA care about droughts?
So most people think of NASA, they think of space, they think of astronauts. But a core part of the agency mission is to study the Earth, and that includes understanding climate change and related phenomena. So things like droughts, floods, extreme rainfall.
I think when a lot of people here in the U.S. think about droughts, they think about, you know, a few weeks without rain, maybe some warnings not to, you know, water their lawn with sprinklers. What are the larger implications of droughts?
Droughts are really about water. And water is essential for pretty much everything that both our societies do and also what ecosystems need. Droughts are not really just a few weeks without rainfall. Droughts can be 20-year-long events like we just ended in the southwest United States, or it can be, you know, multi-year events like the recent droughts in California. Climate change is basically pushing these events into a scale that are really unprecedented. You know, we're looking at droughts that are more intense, that are more persistent than anything that people have had to deal with for, you know, maybe the last 200 years.
So it sounds like in some cases, droughts aren't caused by climate change, but they're influenced by climate change.
No, that's exactly right. You know, droughts are a normal feature of natural variations in the climate system. But what climate change can do is can make it a little more likely that those natural variations can slide a region into drought. Or if a drought does occur, climate change means that that drought might be a bit more severe, a bit worse, a bit drier.
In March of this year, California's drought officially ended after more than 7 years. Just last month, Texas saw a flash drought, one that developed much more rapidly than normal. Only 1% of the state was experiencing drought conditions in May. But by mid-August, that number jumped to 65%.
So we're hearing about a lot of water problems in the western United States and Texas. For people who don't live there, what does that look like on the ground, and what is it likely to look like in the future?
So the drought impacts can be minor inconveniences or potentially, you know, devastating consequences. You know, it can mean things like increased water restrictions, mandatory water savings. You know, you might not be able to, wash your car or water your lawn, right? But at a larger scale, it means impacts on farmers. So it means farmers maybe don't have enough water to, you know, grow crops on their full cropland. So it means reduced revenue for them, reduced food production. In some cases, it can mean big impacts on livestock, you know, that use lands to graze that maybe, you know, are not producing enough forage. And then those kind of impacts can really start to cascade out beyond those local regions because, you know, if people are not growing as much food, it means food prices in the U.S. for people who don't even live there are likely to go up.
Is there a drought that's already occurred that you and your colleagues are pretty sure, pretty confident was influenced by climate change?
Several. So the California drought, for example, it's pretty clear that climate change played a big role in making it as intense as it was. Recent droughts in the Mediterranean and the Middle East, the drought that occurred right before the Syrian Civil War, the recent drought in Cape Town, South Africa, all of these droughts have a pretty clear climate change signal. You know, still predominantly natural, but the evidence is pretty clear that climate change made those droughts worse than they would have been otherwise.
The sad truth is, yes, there are some specific steps we can take to mitigate the effects of droughts. But at the end of the day, big change will only come from tackling the big issue, climate change.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.